Hey guys, it's Shaun Balemi here. I'm a ruminant nutritionist from Agvance. So we're doing a new series on Springer cow management, where we're going to talk about what the Springer period is, how do we manage body condition score going into the Springer period and through the Springer period, and what do we feed our Springer cows, and lastly, what supplements are best used in the Springer cows. So for Springer cow success, we're looking for good peak milk production in the spring. We're looking at getting those cows back in calf. And then obviously we're looking at minimising metabolic disease and maximising immune function in those Springer cows. So the key things around this time is the length of time they're in the Springer mob, what they've been fed in the Springer mob, and then what's happening in the cow through that period. So basically what's happening is there's an extreme diet change going on with her coming off crop or fibrous winter feeds, where she's not eating a lot because she's really just eating enough to put on a bit of condition and meet her own maintenance requirements for energy, protein and nutrient. So with any diet change, it has an impact on the rumen. It takes around 10 to 12 days for the rumen to fully adapt to a change in feed. At this time of the year, the rumen is not just getting used to a change of feed, it's actually got to enlarge because the rumen has to hold a larger amount of feed. Because the type of feed is changing, the rumen microbes have to actually adjust to that feed. So over those 10 days, the type of microorganisms in the rumen actually change to adapt to the new feed that is going into the cow. So lastly, the supplementation of the Springer cow is essential. So you've got the feed right, you've got the length of the Springer period right, but now we need to balance the DCAD, calcium and phosphorus and magnesium levels, and also the trace mineral levels going into the cow. By doing that, we're minimising metabolic disease, we're helping to reduce the amount of post-calving mastitis, and we're also reducing endometritis and ketosis in those cows. So we're aiming for maximum cow performance, and then using supplements to balance her through that Springer transition period. Springer transition cow success means the cow peak milks really well because her rumen is fully transitioned, so she's getting the most out of every kilo she's eating. She's more likely to get back in calf because she comes back out of negative energy balance quicker and starts putting on weight again, coming into the mating period. Her immune system is far stronger and functions better because her health is better. Her liver is functioning better, which helps to increase the amount of energy her body is metabolizing, which also helps drive a reproductive performance. And metabolic disease is minimized because she's mobilizing calcium phosphorus effectively from her bone, which means she's in far better health.